Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I got a very, very good question from Manish in the comments, and that was, when we're dealing with Spring Boot, do I really need to convert all, do I really need to use the built-in conversion of objects to XML or to JSON? Can I just do this manually? Of course you can, and it's also it's very good in the beginning when you're a bit you don't know about what is all this magic that Spring Boot is actually doing. Then you can actually you can actually access the response and actually totally determine what kind of response to be returned from your endpoint, and you can also access the request right here. And then you can list out all the properties from the request. So if you want total control over your request and your response, then that is totally doable. And this is exactly how to do it. Or this is one of the ways how to do it. We still have some magic here. We have a REST controller right here. I've chosen an endpoint right here, which is the first part of the endpoint for all the methods then that I'm going to create inside this REST controller right here. I hope that that you don't mind that. And then we have the get mapping right here, which is the specific mapping for this method right here. So we have the mapping, we have the routes determined by magic, but then we have the response entity as the thing that we are returning, this gives us full control over our REST endpoints. So this means that I can just return plain text if that's what I want to. I can return protobuf or stuff if that's what I want to. I can also return XML, JSON, whatever. I can just choose whatever. I can also just serialize a Java object if that's what I want to. I can return whatever I want to. I can also return all the bytes. First of all, this is a demo. I'm using Val from now on, and that's because again in the comments there was a guy called Jeffrey who asked me why I'm not using Val a bit more, and I will try to use Val a bit more. It's just it's just old habits. And actually, to make this Val work, I had to go to my build.gradle file. I had to set the latest Lombok dependencies like this. I found those on the Lombok webpage. So, but I think it's totally worth it. I really like writing Val instead of repeating myself with the type all the time. But first of all, I want to show that we have full control over the requests, and that means that I will actually get the header. So I'll get the request entity like this. Get headers interested, and this request entity. I do not need to annotate this with anything. When Spring sees, okay, he's adding a request entity as the argument, then this will be injected automatically, and then Spring says, okay, he needs a request and full control over the requests, so just give him that, and then or her, of course. So everything is fine, and then we can use the request entity, and in this case, I'm getting the headers like this, and then I'm getting the intro set right there, and then I'm traversing it through it with a for loop like this, and then I just lock the first value. So that means if there's a key that has more than one value, then I only get the first value with this for loop right here. You can create one that is better, of course, if that's what you want to. But so the first part, print out the request so we can see what kind of headers we're sending. The second part, this is the response, and this is the response to all of this. First of all, I would like to add a header to my response, and I would like to say to my client that this is XML, or this is just a plain dummy string, or whatever it is. It could also be JSON. I want to tell them which content type it is, and that is what I do right here. We can try to outcomment it, then we can see the difference. Then we'll just say plain text, which is the default media type if we don't set anything right there. Then I want to create an XML mapper because I want to actually the question that was actually about how can I return an XML response just in one endpoint without actually having to use the framework. So and if I interpreted the question wrong, then of course just let me know in the comment as usual. But that is how I interpreted the question. So, and of course, when I say XML mapper right here, you can just put in whatever mapper you have. You can, if you want to use protobuffer, just put in protobuffer mapper right there. If you want to put in gibberish string mapper or mustache or whatever, then you just of course replace this line with your own mapper. Then I'm creating a spaceship. So this is my object that I want to create in, well, I want to convert into some string. And then I create a string from the ship with the XML mapper right there. And then I create my response right here. And this is the a very important part. So I use the constructor that takes three arguments. It takes a body, it takes some headers, and then it takes a status. So let's say that I want to return another status, then okay. Then I can also use, I can use my response entity to give another response than okay. So again, this gives us full control of this code right here. But it's a very good, I think this is an excellent example, just to not to praise myself too much. It was a good question, of course. So but this code right here, there's so many truth that lies in this code right here. So but let us see if it works. Of course you want to see if it works. So I will restart the server. The reason why I was started because of course I tried it out just before starting recording this video right here. So here we have the console, and I am shading for it as usual, so let me just place myself in the other corner. Yes. I created this curl script right here that goes to localhost 8080 API 2 and then one ship. Let us try to run this curl script. And here we have it. I added -v for verbose, so that means then we can see all the things that actually happened. And now I'm shading again. I should not have moved me to this corner. No one puts baby in a corner. I'll put myself back in the other corner again. Here we have the spaceship. You can actually see this is the body. This is the response. So we have the spaceship, name Mike, and crew 10, fuel 12%. And up here we have the headers, content type, application XML. And that is the one I added. And so I created this header right here. I also would have a plain text, but let us just check this out in a minute. It's the content length, 72 characters, the date, also something that Spring just puts on. And that's actually it. So let me go back to my custom controller right now. And let me adjust our comment the header. So I do not want to overwrite the header. I do not want to convert this. I do not want to use the XML mapper. I just want to string sval s equals, and then we say ship dot to string. So now it's just a to string representation of the class instead. So let us see how that looks instead. Again, because we are using response entity, we have full control. We are the one in charge. Of course, we still have some default headers which are applied from Spring, but we can choose not to get those if we want to. But I think they're actually pretty good. I like the timestamp, and I also like the length header. But okay, but now it started up. So let us go back to the curl -v. Here we get it. Let me just go in the bottom. That was the old response. So here's a new response. This is a to string representation of my spaceship, Mike Crew 10, 12.0. And here we have a content type text plane, char set UTF-8. So that is the default one that Spring just puts on if we don't have any other. I think actually it could be the server. Actually, we are using an embedded server. So it could also be the embedded Tomcat, if that is the one we are using. Let me just, it is Tomcat I'm using here. So just one runs again, so I get the terminal up here. So this is it. Now it's a string representation instead. I think I will I'll change the code back so it is an XML representation, but I'll upload the code and push the code to GitHub as usual, and then of course you can play around with it as much as you want. So that's one thing we did not see. We're not done yet. We did not see this printout right here. Then we go to the server. Here we have the output. We have hosts. Yeah, we have the host. This is one header that we got from the client. Another header, user agent curl. So that this says it actually curls also applies some headers by default. They are bragging that say this is a user agent curl, and this is the version of curl. Oh, I'm shading. Sorry. Now I'll place baby in the corner again. Here we have user agent right here, and then we have curl 7580, and then we have accept everything star slash star. That means that we can get any kind of response. Any kind of response will be accepted. But let us try to add our own header just to see that it actually comes out in the console. So I'll say my cool header. And then we write some cool value like this. And let us run again. And we got the same response, of course, right down there. Let us look in the application server log. Let us look in the Spring log right here. And then you can actually see here we got my cool header, some cool header. So we have full control of what is going on. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.